either at the national level or transboundary level, and how really to accumulate elements of sustainability into water resources management if sustainability cannot be adopted or integrated as a whole in water resource management. These are some of the interesting topics that he spoke about. Talked about also the difference between sustainability concepts in the Middle East and sustainability in Europe. So we'll leave it here with Dr. Hazem, and we'll come back once the presentation is available. I'm going to talk it now to the second speaker. Our second speaker is Dr. Jean Lopec. He works for Action. You're okay? All right. So let's go back.
So these are the objectives of the forum, mission and the vision, etc. And the forum includes all related links to water in the area, from regional agencies to international agencies, to international development banks, international development Arab main water funds, for example. Arab donor organizations, tenders and projects in the whole area, and Middle East water ministries and authorities. So you don't, if you want to navigate any of these agencies, it's here available under your disposal. This is the services that we provide, and we have for the governance of the forum an international advisory board, which includes experts from the area as well as international experts dealing with water and infrastructure. Who can also help in the forum. Forum has four important pillars. Number one is regional issues. And the forum is not a website. It's an interactive forum like the Facebook. You can comment, you can share, you can like, and every maybe 2 weeks, we will throw a regional issue of importance to the whole area. Maybe about transboundary, maybe about non-revenue water, maybe about SCADA systems, and seek the opinion and the experience of the various experts in the area. For example, here, I forget to say that the most important thing in the forum, it's in English and in Arabic. Because why Arabic? Because the Arabic content of water-related matters in the internet is very weak, almost nothing there. So we will enrich the internet with articles that the participants, the organizers, will write to the forum. And we agreed with some international organizations to have the right to translate the most important articles in their business, which will help the area to fastly transfer the technology and the new articles. I will show you some articles. So one of the, for example, important regional issue that we're gonna start with next week is the Basra water problem. Everybody heard about what's happened in Basra. It's a major issue for Iraq. And here we are proposing solutions. We are not doing any critic to anybody. We want to help how to solve this on the short term, mid term, long term. So this is one of the most important pillars of the forum. The other important pillar is the water articles. Water articles, as I said, we either translate or we write articles, or people can send us articles. After screening these articles, there is no discrimination, there is no something wrong, we publish these articles, but these are technical articles. They are not political or social or media, etc. So you see here we translated important articles about the about the ابتكارات تكنولوجية, water innovation, about also so many articles related to water that usually it's not available in any place. So this is one, the other pillar. Of course, this is English and Arabic. If you go to the English, you will see also the regional issues in English, and you see the water articles, all of them also in English. This is very important for anybody working in, those are very important articles that we also translated into English about day zero of Johannesburg. This is very important for the people to know that a country will run out of water. So what we are talking about, water scarcity, is not a dream, something that could happen in certain countries. Plus, plus. So this is the second pillar. Of course, you can create a post and send, as I said, your article. We screen it. If it's okay, we save it and we disseminate it all over. And you can interact by commenting on all articles, with the regional issues or the selected articles that we talked about. Of course, the article will talk about job vacancies, project financing, but the third important information hub, third pillar is the information hub. Information hub is in English and in Arabic. And we managed up until now to include 1,000 important documents about all the area, in English and in Arabic. Those are the English, and you can go by country. Any country you want to see here, I mean the Middle East. Only the Middle Eastern countries, the Arab countries plus Turkey, Iran. See Iraq. Iceland. Unfortunately, this is not my computer, and I work on Apple. And this is, you know. So those are the studies on Iraq. You will see hundreds of them about Iraq, or about Turkey, about Iran, about Saudi Arabia, Emirates, Oman, any country you can find a lot of studies about it. The other important pillar is the training tools. Those are e-training tools that we collect and we develop. For example, here we have the water governance module, which you can see. I need 2 minutes. Water governance, here you see the course outline. And those are examples for governance, and case studies, real case studies, and a set of recommended readings. We're gonna do this for all e-training courses. Imagine for water networks, for wastewater, etc. We have here also the Middle East Water Forum TV, which includes important videos for learning, whether for students or for the public, from Gaza to Egypt, to Yemen, to Syria, to Iraq, to Jordan, to Palestine, to Sudan, to all important videos, educational videos, by the way. It's not something for the media. And the water products, the technological edge. The forum will include the state of the art technologies related to water. If you want to know what's going on in any field of the technologies, from drilling to wastewater to networks to pipes, the hub will tell you the latest technologies. you don't need to go and search about the new technology in desalination membranes. You will find it here. Also the water products, companies that would like to present their product. Here we have some companies presenting their products, whether it's compact wastewater treatment or drilling equipment or purification technologies. And we put here also, because of the importance of energy food water nexus, a box for all matter related to energy food nexus, and this part of the forum will be managed by University of Surrey in the UK, Institute of Sustainability. They will manage this box for the nexus. So I'm sorry because I was a little bit, so this is the forum which will help water utilities, academia, media, normal people to understand the water issue with its integrity. Because water is not water resources, water is not water supply, water is not technology, water is not industry, water is a collective, integrative work of all these members of water. So we will rely, of course, on the feedback that we will get from the industry, from the academia, from the utilities, to supply us with their state-of-the-art studies, technologies, projects they want to present. So this hub, with time, is going to be more and more valuable. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Hazem, for introducing the Water Forum, the Middle East Water Forum. Very interesting in terms of building interactive platform, data bank and data portal for all applications related to water and water management, and also allowing the collective learning and the e-learning through cost-effective manner. And I hope in the future we see people also, you know, organizing webinars on the forum, discussion and talk shows where people, they will participate from different countries and share experiences. If you have any urgent question, burning question on the forum, we'll take one or two questions. Otherwise, you know, we can discuss later at the end of the session. Any questions? Yes, Susan.
Just a small query. If this forum will include also the names of the experts, water experts?
Sorry, I forgot to talk about it. The forum will continue professional e-chatting, where we will certify experts from all disciplines. Why this is important? Because usually if you work in a utility or a company and you want to ask something, you don't need to hire a consultant for $50,000. You just said, I have this problem with this pumping station, or I have this phenomena with the wastewater treatment plant. Anybody can help. You will find a lot of experts that will respond to such an inquiry.
Okay, thank you. All right, so I think, you know, we move on now. Our second speaker, Jean Lopec, he comes from Action Against Hunger. He has more than 25 years of experience working on water and sanitation in conflict areas. He authored articles and books dealing with the subject, and he's part of many important organizations worldwide looking at water and sanitation in conflict areas. So we're going to hear about, you know, sustainability from a different elements, how to improve and advance sustainability when you work in stressed areas and conflict areas.
Thank you, Dr. Daoud. So
As you said, I'm working from an NGO called Action Against Hunger. We are present in Jordan and in the region, and also in 56 countries. And the topic of this NGO is to fight against hunger and undernutrition. So for us, water security is very important, because if you don't have water, you don't have food. And also, if you don't have water, or if you have poor quality water, you've got infections, and then you get undernutrition. So our organization is the staff is 8,000 people, and we are serving in terms of water and sanitation 6 million people every year, essentially, as you said, in conflict areas and natural disasters environments. What I'm going to present here very briefly is an experience we have about water resource management in the southwest of Madagascar. It's a country which is under climate stress. It's a semi-arid context, and it's also a very complex geological context. It's a karst. So all the conditions are there to make your life very difficult when you want to deliver secure water to the people. The partners of this project, so you've got, of course, Action Against Hunger, but what is interesting to keep in mind is that we've got both partners from the north, but also partners from Madagascar. And we published recently an article on this project, so if you are more interested, you can connect to me, or you can go online and find the article. There were three main objectives in this research. The first one is an operational objective. We are doing research, but our main focus is to serve people. So it was to be able to site boreholes in the complex environment. The second objective was to create an observatory in order to monitor the resource, and especially in this very variable context. And the last one was to characterize the issue of climate change in the south of Madagascar, and to advocate, of course, for improving measures, especially adaptative measures, against climate change. So here you've got the area. If you focus on the... You see here, this is the intervention area. It's the southwest of Madagascar. So it's a karstic area,